My wife and I, Colette, have been coming to New Life for about 40 years now. We became members about 6 years after we started coming. When we came to New Life, we were just in the process of starting a family. My wife was raised Catholic, I was raised Baptist, and we were looking for a church to raise our family. Not necessarily a religion, but a church that we could call home. And New Life filled that bill. As most of you know, I'm a retired firefighter from the Bolingbrook Fire Department. I started as a volunteer with the fire department back in 1974. And I didn't know a thing at all about firefighting. In June of 1975, I was sworn in as the 13th full-time member of the fire department. And the Bolingbrook Fire Department became a part of my life, and it became a major part of the Storman family. Firefighting is not an easy job, not only because of the training we do daily, but mainly because we only get called when something catastrophic is happening in a person's life or a family's lives. I had always wished that just once someone would call and say, "Hey, I just took a batch of cookies out of the oven and sent the guys over." Unfortunately, that never happens. Most of the time, it's a life-threatening situation or a life-altering event. Everyone on the fire department knows that my family and I attend New Life, and that I'm a Christian. When I started, I was a firefighter paramedic. And many times on the way to a call, I would silently say a quick prayer for guidance in doing my job, and to help someone or to save a life, and to guide us safely to the hospital. As I moved up the ladder, I became a lieutenant, and I was in charge of a fire company. My prayers would be a little bit quicker and more to the point due to my responsibility in supervising my crew. The prayer would be something like, "Please keep my crew safe and the public safe, and help us to do our jobs to the best of our ability." It was during my years of being a lieutenant that on occasions, as my crew would be doing CPR or in some other way saving a person's life, that someone would come up to me, not often, would just say, "Are you a religious person?" To which I would answer yes. And they would say, "Could you say a prayer?" And I would say, "Absolutely, I will." And I did. The next step up the ladder was to that of battalion chief, which meant I was responsible for all 5 fire stations and about 28 firefighters. When I went on a call, it meant that we had multiple fire stations responding, and it was usually of a larger scale and more dangerous, not only to the victims, the public, or the residents of a building, if it was a building fire, but it was also more dangerous to my firefighters because they're running into a building that's getting weaker by the minute. And our main job is to make sure that everybody else was out of that building. All of my firefighters knew that I almost always said a short prayer for guidance, and for me and my crews, and the wisdom for me to make the right decisions on how to mitigate the incident. I would ask to keep everyone safe prior to me sending crews in to a burning building, and even more so if there was a rescue involved, because I know my firefighters would take more chances, just like I did when I was in their boots. That was the most stressful part of my career, but also the most rewarding. Many times after a major incident, and things would kind of settle down and slow down, my firefighters would come up to me and ask me if I talked to the man. And I would basically say, is everybody out safe? And then I guess he hurt me. I'm not saying no one ever got hurt, because they did. It's the nature of the job. But I thank God to this day, and I do every day, that I never had to make a phone call telling someone that their husband, their wife, or their mom or dad wasn't coming home. Christ in the church has always been a big part of my family growing up and my life, as well as my family. It's nice for me to sit here with my two children and their families now, as they grow in their faith and they remain a part of new life. My Christ in Motion story actually continues a little bit, because a few months ago I got a phone call, and it was from a firefighter that's currently on the fire department. And his dad and I were hired together and we worked together. And he said, "Rich, do you still go to New Life Lutheran Church?" I said, "Yes, I do." He said, "Could you tell me a little bit about it?" To which I did. Well, he and his wife started coming, and last week, their son was baptized here. So, my Life in Motion story, even though I've been gone for 10 years, still continues. And I thank God every day that he chose me to become a firefighter and gave me the ability to affect so many others. Thank you.